Welcome to the Greens, where while some people might have megafauna, we have megaflora. I'm Rob Peters, and we have a very exciting bunch of news for you. So let's try not to have this take more than a minute to get to it. On to the news. Business is blooming in Greenmart, our new store that's opened a couple of weeks ago. I am super excited to say this because we have always wanted to open a store here in the Greens that is not owned by a big company like Walmart or the other ones. That's all I wanted to say. Sorry if I sound a little preoccupied. There seems to be some sort of rash on my arm and it's been itching like crazy recently, so I'm sure it's nothing to worry about. It's probably just a brush by with some poison oak. Now, on to our weekly events. Weirdly enough, the weekly events are few and far between recently. However, there are two very exciting things that I want to mention today. On Wednesday, we are finally announcing that we are planning on building a Greens library. This is something that many people have been wanting to see here at the Greens. And I personally think that adding a library is a really good thing, because that means you will be able to more easily get your local Greens Botanic Encyclopedias. Yes, we have decided to change it from a flora encyclopedia to a botanic encyclopedia, because that just sounds easier to say. Here's a friendly reminder that the Greens Botanic Encyclopedias are extremely useful, as they contain information such as proper growing habitats for daffodilies, proper diets for Venus flytraps, and the easiest way to survive an encounter with a purple-spotted chokeweed. Besides a new library, there is also going to be a meteor shower on Friday. Make sure to bring your flytraps. They will greatly appreciate the incredible sight of a meteor shower. It's been a while since we've had one here in the Greens, after all. Apparently, local authorities have found a dog in a cave somewhere. This dog seems to be a bit on the large side and is rather lazy. Its diet mainly consists of fish and berries. So if you want to adopt a dog, then there is one available for you in that cave that is mostly on the outskirts of the Greens. I'm sure you all know the one. Now, make sure to... false alarm. It's a bear. You are not allowed to adopt that bear. Please do not go to the cave on the outskirts of the Greens. You know the one. There is now officially a bear living there. Just to let you know. Sorry about that, folks. This rash has been getting a whole lot worse since I started. This is very itchy. Again, I'm sure it's nothing to worry about. I'll just keep going with my reporting. I have managed to get some more info on that thing that showed up in the center of the Greens a few weeks ago. I decided to go down to see what it was, and it seemed to be some sort of large black cube. And by large, I mean it is more than house-sized. It's very, very large. And it seemed to have some sort of writing on it. However, it wasn't in any language that I recognized, or anyone else could seem to recognize. In fact, I'm not even entirely sure it's a language that is of this world, so... make sure to try and stay away from whatever it is, because we have no idea what it is, and again, better safe than sorry. I don't want anyone getting hurt from it. And now, sports. Now, again, I am not a subject on the matter. In fact, I am very sports inept, but I think I might be starting to get a vague grasp on the subject. So, Recently, we got another win in our football team. However, there has been a rumor of some sort of scandal going around where someone's doing something that makes it so that they're better at the game, but in a way that's illegal or, I don't know. Again, I know nothing about sports, so maybe you should just look up this one on an actual sports website. It's probably a whole lot better than me at this kind of stuff. And now, a word from our sponsors, Panini. And now, a public service announcement. There has been a rumor that has been going around that rubber is banned in the greens. I just want to point out, it is not banned in the greens. It's just that we don't have any reason to use it. And now, our weekly forecast. The first half of this week will be mostly sunny. There will be a...
Don't worry, folks. I'm fine. There will be a chance of rain in some of these days, but most of the time it will be sunny. It will be a lot more rainy on the other half of the week.
In some other news, the building that has been on the outskirts of the greens, that has been abandoned since who knows how long ago, is going to be demolished. Now, the reason that it wasn't demolished before is because it has had a wicked vine infestation, and as such, because we don't want to hurt our flora, we've decided to keep it as a sanctuary. However, we've managed to safely relocate all of the vines, and now that building is going down. So, if you happen to have any belongings in that abandoned building, then please retrieve them before it gets blown up. I'm not sure why you would have belongings in that old abandoned building, but just in case, you know? And now traffic. As per usual, there is no traffic because the vines have infested the entire road. However, there is some very unrelated news next. Apparently, we are having a lemon shortage. Which means that all the people who have been running lemonade stands should probably stop. Because apparently, we are using up far too many lemons, and that is a big problem for our citrus fanatics. Alright, let's move on to... Oh,
that's definitely not normal.
This rash has gotten a whole lot worse since I started, and I'm starting to think that it's not just a brush by with just a little bit of poison oak. So, I'm going to talk to the station medical team real quick. While I'm gone, please enjoy the sounds of the rainforest. I'll be back before you know it. No need to worry about me.
sincerest apologies, but it turns out that Robin Peters had a severe medical condition and had to be rushed to emergency care. Your news will have to wait.